Hundreds more state employee layoff notices scheduled to go out this week. Union leaders are meeting to determine if they can change their bylaws to have a second vote on that big concession deal. Our chief Capitol correspondent, Mark Davis, following the very latest live from our Hartford newsroom. Good afternoon, Mark. Is this going to happen?
I don't know, Keith. There are a couple of stumbling blocks appearing on the horizon today. Good afternoon, everyone, from the Hartford newsroom. There has been a series of meetings throughout the weekend, and more are continuing today with the union leadership saying they want to try to avert what they say are catastrophic cuts in state government services and affecting their members. The leaders of the 15 state labor unions representing more than 30 bargaining units must come up with a way to change the rules for ratifying any concession deal. A new deal would have to allay some members' fears about changes in their health care coverage and would have to roll back pay raises that went into effect July 1st. But given the 1,000 layoff notices last week, hundreds more this week, and the closing down of many state services announced by the Malloy administration, some union members are apparently changing their mind.
At this point, we've heard, and I can only say anecdotally, from a lot of members who have voted no initially, who have said, given a chance, I would vote yes. We've also heard from folks who voted no who say, I stand by that vote.
Now, it has also been expected that the union leaderships would have some sort of decision to announce sometime today, but they appear to be backing away from that at this hour. It's clear that the next move in all of this is theirs, and almost everyone at the Capitol feels they must act. Now, also this midday, we wanted to issue a quick correction to the reports we did that I did personally on Friday evening about Malloy's big cutbacks in services. We said that the unemployment office, that is the job center in Waterbury, was closing. That was incorrect. It is the Office of the Commission on Human Rights and Opportunity in Waterbury that's closing. We apologize. And we'll have the very latest on all of this coming up starting at 5 and at WTNH.com throughout the day. Live from the Hartford newsroom, Mark Davis, News 8.